Hello everyone, my name is Aparajita and this video is about resume building. So before I start this video, I want to tell you that all the tips which I have given in this video and the slides are of my experiences, are taken from my experiences, and some of them are from the career fairs or the workshops which I have attended previously and currently at my university, at University of Illinois at Chicago. So I hope this video helps, and let's get started. So many companies, they ask for your resume, they ask you to upload your resume on their website or the portal, and then it goes through a number of processes, and one of them is once you upload your resume to their portal, a system scans your resume or reads your resume and filters some of them, and then it's forwarded to a human being who checks it manually or who process it further. So this tracking system is called application tracking system. It's used by organizations to manage the flood of application they receive throughout the year or for a specific job position. So ATS, it reads your resume and then rank it and score it, your qualification versus the job descriptions. So the high scorers are filtered out and then they, undergo various processes. So the top five tips which I would like to give you so that your resume is filtered out from the ATS system is use a standard Word document and save it in .doc format, because many ATS systems, they cannot read PDF, JPG and other formats. The second is use simple formatting. So for example, if you're writing your work experience, it should have like 4 or 5 bullet points below the title called work experience or below the name of the company, the employer. And then you can write like handled this, analyzed this, worked on this, like that. So it's better to use bullet points and do not use symbols, lines or borders, etc. Let's keep it simple. The third is customize each resume for a specific job role or company. One size fits all, this phrase, this policy doesn't work with ATS. Suppose you're applying for a marketing job. So your summary, your skills, your work experience, it should be relevant to the job position you're applying for. Suppose you're applying for an operations job. So, you should provide, you should showcase those skills which are relevant to the job description. And the fourth one is be specific with keywords. When ATS reads your resume, it looks for keywords like operations, project management, contract, like something which is there in the job description. So if suppose your job description says they want people who knows Camtasia or who knows Microsoft Excel, who knows PowerPoint. So if you write that keyword in your resume, the ATS filters it, and there's a the probability of getting you selected will be more. So for example, you're writing Camtasia. Instead of writing video editing software, you will write Camtasia. And the fifth one is check spelling, because the misspelled words, ATS won't recognize the misspelled words. So it's better to check that before uploading it to a portal. You can use certain softwares like Grammarly.com. It provides you with underlined words which are wrong or grammatically wrong or spellings are wrong. So it's better to use certain software before uploading your resume to any company's portal. Now comes the do's. So do remember to submit a resume to the company's ATS, even if you have a personal connection to your network. Like suppose one of my friend is working in a company XYZ, and he told me that there's a job opening. So you send me a resume and I'm going to forward it to my manager. Okay, that works. But that person should also upload your resume to the ATS or to the portal of that company. And the second one is do use the exact job title on your resume. So suppose I was working in a company ABC and my role was a procurement specialist. So while writing the work experience from that company, we need to write the exact title given to us by the company.
And the third one is do list dates to the right of the education or the work experience information. Suppose you're writing your work ex. So I worked in a company XYZ for 2 years. So you have to write the duration from like September 2018 to September 2020 on the right side of the work experience of the job role you have written in your resume. Then comes the headers. Do consider section headers to be all in caps. Like this is one of my suggestion, but you can do whatever you want to. Like it's your resume. So suppose you're writing education. So that education should be in all caps, and then you write like master's in this, bachelor's in this, like that. Then do use text of reasonable size and standard fonts. So it's better not to, design your resume. Just keep it simple. So the reasonable size would be 11, 12. I think it goes to 14. It totally depends on, it totally depends on you. Like, but we should not use sizes above like 14 at least. I prefer 12. It depends on you, I tell you. And standard fonts, so it could be Arial, Times Roman, Calibri, all those fonts. And the last one is do check your email for your submission acknowledgement, and don't forget to check the spam folder. Sometimes you get an automated acknowledgement email saying that we have received your application for this XYZ position in our company. So now you know that, okay, you have uploaded your document, your resume to their portal. So those emails, it can be in your spam folder too. So for a safer side, you can check your spam folder. Then comes don'ts. Don't list your credentials like MBA, MS next to your name. Like suppose I'm writing Abrajita, MS in this, this, this. Not next to my name, or PhD, MS, Aparajita, like that. So let's just keep it included in the separate line, in a separate line, or where the educational part is in your resume. And don't mix different fonts and sizes in your resume. Suppose I'm using Times Roman for writing the titles, work experience, and I'm using Arial for writing the bullet points. So let's not do it. Let's just use one font and one size for all of the text we are including in the resume. Then don't include skills which you don't have. You are trying to trick the ATS. That won't work because you have to, go through a process, and once you land at the last step, the interview process, the interviewer will ask you that, do you know this? And you'll be like no. So instead of writing something which is not true, let's just write what skill set you have, and let's just, try to showcase what you have. Don't waste an opportunity. Then don't exceed your resume to 3 pages or more. Keeping it 1 to 2 pages are preferred. Like, I prefer keeping my resume to 1 page, although I have an experience of certain years, but I have to fit all those bullet points and content in 1 page. Because, no one has time to read like 2, 3 pages. But it's your resume, so you can do whatever you want. The last one is don't add too much personal information. So a resume, it's more of a professional thing and not a personal document. So it's better to write about your professional life, like your work ex and your academic projects, your certification. So for freshers, they don't have work experience, so they can write about their, bachelor's degree or about their master's degree or about their, educational projects, their academic projects, and some of their, extracurricular activities, but not too much. And for the people those who are experienced, they can write about their work experience and the internships and project works and stuff. Now, this is something I noted down while I was attending a workshop by Amazon, like a career workshop by Amazon. He said that you have to quantify your achievements. It's like, so your job, suppose your job is scheduling meetings for your manager or for XYZ. So you just write as schedule meetings. It's better to write, I schedule or I scheduled 100 meetings in the last month. So 100, like you're giving the quantity, and which shows that, okay, you have the capacity to do this much work. That was the example he gave. And he also said, show, don't tell. Suppose in my last company, I did a project or I, wrote a code. So you're writing this much. Okay, I did this. But what was the impact of the code you wrote? Or what was the benefits you have given to the company? So you have to write that. You cannot tell them, okay, I did this. You have to show them that I did this and this happened. So there was an impact of what I did. Then objective statements or initial summary section as per the JD is a must. So before attending this workshop, there was no space in my resume. So I thought, let me not write the summary or let me not write the, the first 2 lines of the resume. I will just showcase my skills and that's enough. But after I attended this workshop, I'm like, oh my God, I'm missing one of the, in one of the very important statement or 2 lines of my resume, and they might reject my resume because I did not write the summary. So sometimes they don't have the time. They'll just read your summary and they'll be like, okay, now I should go further because the summary is good. But if I don't write my summary, they're not gonna read it. I think they'll reject it. So these were the learnings I got from attending the workshops or the career fairs or reading on internet and some of the content from UIC. So thank you so much for watching this. I hope it's helpful. Bye.